going on, everybody? It's a very, very special time of year. It's February. And that means it's hammers time. I just picked up my trailer. It's a 18-foot Milan Light from OCRV. Gary from OCRV. He's a fucking champ. He always takes care of me. I had to run around the city to take care of the wiring because the plug that I had on there in the factory was no bueno. Let me get the light going here so we can. So the light. So everything's all zip tied up and everything, but I got the adapter, the GM adapter, to go to the right plug because it had this funky old school hoppy whatever thing. It's not right. Nothing about it was right. Got the dirt diggler in the back and everything else, all the ice, the cooler, all the food from Wahoo's. Thank you again, Wahoo's. Shout out, Wing. Thank you so much. Getting us set up. And I'm about to hit the road. Trailer in tow. Fucking get it. Let's do this. Hammers 2017.
Starting route to a King of the Hammers.
So the traffic heading out is really bad. I mean, it's, you know, 6 o'clock, still rush hour here in California. I'm on the 60 heading to the 15. So I figured this would be kind of a good time I could take to tell you a little bit about the King of the Hammers. A lot of people probably are watching this. Maybe they've never heard about it. It was created by Dave Cole and a bunch of his buddies. There's an area called Johnson Valley, and they have all these really wild trails, and a lot of them are named after different hammers, like Sledgehammer and Jackhammer. And they decided to do this race. I think there was like 14 guys or something that originally did the race, and it was through the lake bed, so like the flats. So it was high speed, and then you'd also have to crawl through the hard, like, rock sections. And this was the first of its kind. Truly, like, a completely new motorsport. The cars that have been developed through through like all the years of King of the Hammer racing, they're insane, because they're like part Jeep, part trophy truck, part like Class One. It's pretty nuts to see what these guys have had to develop to deal with high-speed desert racing and low-speed, very technical rock crawl, very technical rock crawling. So over the years, the race has really just built a wild following because it's so intense. Like, the race is just nuts, and so many people come out for it that there's 60 to 80 to, I don't know, maybe there'll be 100,000 people on the lake bed this year. That's nuts. So this year I'm going out and meeting up with All American Off-Road, Shane. Start that over. So this year I'm meeting up with Shane from All American Off-Road, as well as Cody and Tom from GG Lighting, who you saw in the Barstow video recently. And we're gonna have a big party on Thursday night, inviting whoever wants to come out, come check it out. I'm gonna have my scooter, which I can't wait to ride around the pits, because they have a big vendor area where everybody goes and sets up, and they show off like their bumpers and their lights and winches and you know, seats and things like that. And they have a jumbotron where everyone can go and watch the race. So that's really cool, with a big fire pit in the middle, like this huge bonfire that they build every year. So I'm gonna ride the scooter around the pits. That's gonna be a blast. You guys know I love my fucking scooters. I'm such a geek. Such a fucking geek. Also, while we're in the car, let me give you the trailer the trailer story. So I pull up, we get the trailer hooked up, and I go to plug in the wiring, and the connector's totally different. It has like, anyways, I had to take a break. I had to merge over. I got a little hairy. Alright, so yeah, me and Gary, we get the trailer hooked up. I go to plug in the wiring, and the connector's just like completely fucking different. Like, not even close. It's got not enough pins, the connectors are totally different, and everything was just wrong. And Gary looks at the piece and he's like, I have never seen that piece before in my life. And I've been doing this trailer thing for 9 years and I've done over 4,000 different rentals. And I'm like, oh, well, of course, it goes to figure that I have the only truck with the weird connector on it. It's always my luck that something like that happens. So he gets on the horn, calls up a trailer supply place that's nearby, he's telling him what we got, and he's like, dude, I don't know what you have, I don't know what you're talking about, maybe I can like splice it together tomorrow. And I'm just like, you know what, let me get the address, I'm going down there and I'm gonna figure it out. It was like 20 minutes away. I think I got there in 10. Pulled up, got the guy from the inside, pulled him out and said, hey, can you just look at my truck real quick at the wiring I have? I pulled all the OEM wiring down. And he's like, oh, that? Yeah, that's no problem, dude. Yeah, everyone makes these things. Connector, $17. Plugs right in the OEM harness. Sent a picture to Gary. He's like, yep, that's what you need. Drove back, got it hooked up, and here we are on the road. Traffic is just, you know, predictably stupid. That's just how it is, especially on the 15 at this time, heading north. It's always bad, no matter what day of the week it is.
A few moments later.
All right, finally here. We're at the main road that leads into the Hammers. It's just dirt road. It's not as bad as last year. It's not as washed out. It's pretty smooth so far. And take this into camp, go find everybody, and hopefully get parked up pretty quickly. All right, everybody. Got one of the staples of the desert. Nice jacket and coat. There you go. Got the trailer. Let's turn on the light and show it around. You know, little bed, bunk bed, potty, missing vanity, fridge, not full of beer yet, microwave, another bed, storage stuff. Just, you know, all the basic stuff you get in a trailer. I gotta go out, I gotta pull the generator out of there. And, get that hooked up. I'm just gonna leave this connected because I'm not driving around my truck that's on 20-inch wheels all over the desert. That's what I got the Diggler for. I'm in the kitchen. I'm cooking up some dinner. Making some sausage and souse and some shells. And I'm like, oh, fuck. I feel so tired. I feel like I'm just wrecked. And then I look at the time, it's like 10 o'clock. But it's hard to know what time it is when you look around you. There's no clock and there's, I mean, all the lights are always the same. Ooh!
Those are desert lights, though. Oh, yeah.
So we're up here, we're on Chocolate Thunder, and I'm not exactly sure what's going on, but there's a two-wheel drive Jeep connected to a four-wheel drive Toyota getting connected to another four-wheel drive Jeep. And they want to like tug this thing up the hill to try to get off the hill. But I told them, I'm like, if you just take it, unhook it, and drive it around, you'll be in the clear. But they want to play tug of war or something and drag this thing up. So let's sit back and watch and enjoy. Sweet, sweet freedom.
I like that. turn into a shit show up here, so we're gonna head back down. Oh, by the way, this is Jeff. Jeff has a green Jeep. Let's say hi to Jeff. Hello, Jeff.
Hola.
So there's a lot of like high buck stuff out here, like this, you know, Endeavor, triple slider, whatever, Class A motorhome. But look at this bad boy. From Massachusetts. Toyota Coachman. And he made it into his own toy hauler. The hinges and everything. That's rad right there.
And we've got Bailey Cole showing 42 miles an hour as he heads on towards the finish. Don't forget, he took off side by side. Bailey Cole and Rick Barnard side by side taking off first today.
So this is the Jumbotron. This is where everyone comes out to watch the race. And they usually have like a big fire going right there. They haven't got that going yet.
133.
It's pretty cool because you can watch the race and you don't have to go out on the trails if you want to be lazy. All right, back to camp now. And I'm whooped already. A whole day in the desert, running around, climbing, doing the photo shoot earlier. So now we got to get set up for the party tonight. It's gonna be a lot of work. Let's do this.
Am I going to this? I don't know. Let's see, dude. We went up there. It was jammed.
Hey, up in the backwoods, down in the hall. Yeah. Old boy spinning like a dog on a collar. Keeping that chain pulled tight.
Hi. Saturday
night.
Just a tree stump.
You know what?
I would have.
Damn it! It's not from California, is it?
I would have.
Today's race day, and it's really, really busy here as always. There's just tons of people coming in, going out. A lot of people,
you know, mobbing in the desert. Like to go mobbing. Well, maybe not mobbing. You know, they're out there mobbing.
Anyways, I forgot to charge this, so I gotta get this camera back charged, and we're gonna go check out some of the race spots today.
That'd be so
cool. Well, it looks like it's happened a couple times. Yeah. I mean, it's pretty fresh dirt. So this is one of the race course points you can come out to and watch the cars come through. And we came at a good time because there's a lot of traffic coming up through the track right now. Some of these guys are hauling ass.
yourself, huh?
Gonna bring the Yamaha out here tonight.
Yamaha.
And hit this section.
That'd be sick.
Dude, get stuck in 4 seconds.
It's not very tall, huh?
No.
Through here, there's like a soft berm around a big boulder, and then there's like a rock section. We keep wondering why people take the soft berm when you could just go over the, like, literally the rocks is nothing. You could sail over it. So every time one of the...
It must have to do with the way it lines them up the next section.
I don't think so.
Or they're just trying to conserve their car by not slamming into so many rocks.
Those rocks aren't bad, though. And they take their car and they slam it right up against the freaking boulder. Gonna go. He's gonna take the soft berm of the rocks. He's going soft berm. See, and I don't get it, because then you have to wedge yourself around that rock and then turn hard. Why don't you just go straight through that rock section? It's so easy. And then again, I'm a guy sitting on the side of a sand hill with an umbrella. I'm not strapped into a race truck, so what do I know? Pissed off.
Is he going?
He's taking the rocks. Yeah!
Much faster.
Way faster. Gonna pack up from this spot and head out to another one.
That sand is still about 2/3 of the way down. These guys are all safe in their cars.
Amazing to me how, like, vast, just how vast and open this whole area is, and there's people everywhere you go. It's incredible how many people come out for this race. Well, this is a really famous spot. It's called Back Door, and this year they're running down it. So let's check it out. The rocks on this section are huge, like 8 feet tall. Hell yeah, that's how you get out of there.
love that other lane.
Made it back to camp from checking out all the race spots. I don't know what we're gonna do next, but definitely gonna eat and crack some old cold ones. Go back inside the white box. What do you say we go ride the scooter around?
Hey, buddy. You're welcome. Thank you.
Anyway,
we rolled a car on this flat on the last time up Wrecking Ball. I just got some cars. We got it rolled back over and threw our belt off about eight. I don't know how many times Chip got out of the car.
So this is Hammertown. And it's where everyone comes to watch the Jumbotron. They see the race and all the drivers come up over the podium to, you know, thank everybody and all that racer crap.
We were loving life.
Max's tires brought us through. Vision X brought us home when under the lights. I'm sure I'm deep Betty vodka. We've got to go drink a little bit of that now. I'm sure I'm missing a bunch of guys, but it was a great day.
Well, I do have some really awesome things for you here. You get your very
They also have a big old bonfire over there, so people hang out here at night.
Isn't that awesome?
Cool.
You get a key,
and I love riding the GoPet through because everyone looks at it. A lot of fun.
Actually, let me tell you, it says finisher. There's a lot of people out here that like to say that they've got it. That's like your Super Bowl ring. That's actually super sick. You're my hero. I can't believe you just did it.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, so what's your plan next? Go relax, go party? You got, okay, hold on, lovely wife, come here. We've got lovely wife, dying to kiss her man. All right, Doug Jackson, you did a great job. I'm so proud of you guys. Now, Kodog, let me ask you, at any point, were you like,
I didn't really film anything last night. It was kind of a boring night. Came back to camp, made some dinner, watched Meet the Fockers, and Cody's trailer. And I hung out by the fire for a little bit. By a little bit, I mean, all of a sudden we look at our phone and it's 1:40 in the morning. We're gonna take out the Razor today. I think we're going out to Landers. I think there's like a bar out in the middle of the desert, Cody was saying. So, let me take you guys along for the ride.
Typical KOH Saturday morning with the endless stream of trucks, trailers, and rigs leaving the campground. I might stay till tomorrow morning. I think it'll be a little nice just to get another day to relax, do nothing. Today we'll probably be driving this around. let's see if we can make that happen. This is the KOH Jeep Ride Experience. Basically, anybody can come out here with their Jeep and they meet up with one of the guys that helps organize the racetrack. And they go and they run the course. And we just stumbled upon it running through the lake bed. So there's about 50 Jeeps out here. Pretty cool. This is one of the parts of the trail. This is one of the parts of the race course. Hey, you got a beer already, dude? Fuck, what about me? Hold on a second. How's your wedgie?
It's gone now. You can see my little pee-pee string though.
Aw, little pee-pee string.
But yeah, everyone just comes out here and just fucking gets it. So cool, it's a turbo four cylinder and it's a right-hand drive. That is a cool crawler. They've been I think Laser Nut's been drinking.
Yeah, he's like not even slow.
You motherfuckers want to see how you do this? Laser Nut, coming up. Just pick whatever the fuck line he wants. And when you've been drinking since 10 a.m. That Laser Nut car is insane. Front and rear independent. Like a $500,000 build. Just came up here and ripped it. Spots called back door. We were here yesterday where we saw that car 602. That guy was stranded there all night. But also during that time you can't get close. So I'm gonna walk into the canyon and get close to these cars a little bit. Let's check it out. That was entertaining. So we're gonna head back out of back door and go to camp. I'm hungry. We're all hungry. Time for some footage. It started raining out here. And we got a big fire going. It's actually pretty nice. It's just kinda like a heavy sprinkle. And people are just leaving the place. You can see everyone coming down from Thunder and all the other courses up there. Everyone's on like full evacuation mode. It's pretty funny. So we could stay one last night and head out in the morning. Starting to rain a little harder than we thought it was going to. I checked out the Doppler. We're gonna have like a nice big yellow cell coming right over us. So I'm gonna grab some food to cook over at Cody's. We're gonna make some dinner.
get something tasty to eat.
Well, the rain got finished up out here. Before that, we went inside, cooked some dinner, and watched Meet the Parents. That would be so funny, the Gaylord Fokker. Everyone's back out at the campfire, and that's pretty much gonna end up for this video. Thanks for checking out King of the Hammers with me, and GG Lighting, Ashley, Tom, Cody, and everybody else that came out. Shane, of course, and Jeff with the big green Jeep. Thanks again for watching. If you could, hit that subscribe button. If you really wanted to, hit that like button as well. I would appreciate it. It's always cool to see people are enjoying the videos and like what I'm doing here. So thanks again for watching. See you in the desert.